It's Science Thursday on The Rundown. I'm Hari Sreenivasan. Thanks for joining us. So,
if you go see a movie with a superhero, at least I wonder sometimes, what's the scientific reality? How plausible is this? Well, in order to help us answer that question, with us now, from the University of Minnesota, thanks to the wonder of the internet, Jim Kakalios. We are talking to him partly because he wrote a book on this exact question called The Physics of Superheroes. Jim, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you very much for having me, Hari.
Okay, first off, let's talk Spider-Man. How realistic and how strong is spider silk?
Real spider silk has a tensile strength, pound for pound, 5 times greater than steel cable, and is actually stretchier than nylon. Spider silk is an amazing material. It consists of nanometer-sized rigid crystallites that provide strength and rigidity, connected by stretchy polymers that provide elasticity, all in a fluid-filled channel to uniformly distribute the forces along the length of the webbing. Real spider silk, if we could manufacture this in the laboratory, we would be able to make lightweight clothing that would be stronger than Kevlar. We have been unable to duplicate it in the lab, and so scientists have actually taken a page from the Amazing Spider-Man movie and are looking at cross-species genetics, where they take the web-making gene from spiders and have transplanted it into goats, presumably because it's easier than trying to milk a spider. But the goats produce the spider web in their milk that can be sieved, collected, and processed. If Spider-Man's webbing, as shown in The Amazing Spider-Man, is anything like spider silk, then it would indeed be able to hold a car dangling off of the Williamsburg Bridge, provided the diameter of the webbing is large enough.
Okay, let's switch superheroes for a second. Batman, we've seen him leaping off tall buildings, and this soft cape turns incredibly rigid, and then it turns into almost like a hang glider. How close are we in reality to getting some sort of a material like that?
Surprisingly close, actually. Those type of materials that Batman's cape is composed of are what we would call piezoelectrics, materials that change their structural properties upon application of an electric field. There's many materials that do indeed change their structural properties, their rigidity, their crystal structure upon the application of an electric field. The problem lies, however, in the hang glider cape itself. A group of physics graduate students led by David Marshall at the University of Leicester recently published a paper where they analyzed a scene in Batman Begins, where Batman leaps off a skyscraper and is able to glide down by converting his loose-flowing cape into a rigid, you know, parasail. The problem is, if you analyze it from a point of view of classical mechanics, he starts too high and he doesn't fall long enough, doesn't go long enough to decrease his velocity enough, so that you find that he will be going, in the best case scenario, when he strikes the ground, at nearly 50 miles an hour. You're not going to want to do this more than a few times, and might explain why in the latest Batman film it's noticed that there's practically no cartilage left in his knees whatsoever.
Okay, and so how often are big-time Hollywood directors coming to scientists and saying, hey, help me make this real?
Actually, it's surprisingly frequent. So much so that the National Academy of Sciences has set up the Science and Entertainment Exchange to matchmake academics and Hollywood film and television creators. They don't want to make something that's 100% scientifically accurate, because that would defeat the whole purpose of the escapist fantasy that we've paid our money to see. But rather, they need to get it right enough that the audience buys into and doesn't stop and question the suspension of disbelief that they made going into the film. Because any time where an audience is looking at something and saying, that's not right, is a moment when they're not paying attention to the story. So while I don't go to the movies with a pad of paper and a calculator and say, ooh, my physics sense is tingling, they do try to get it right enough that the audience will then be engaged in the story.
All right. Jim Kakalios from the University of Minnesota. If you want to know more about this, you can check out this book called The Physics of Superheroes. Thanks so much for joining us, Jim.
Thank you very much.
This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Sreenivasan. Stay with us.